Today, we will teach you how to create an incredibly explosive movie short film. Okay, let's first take a look at the result. The overall effect is actually imitating a scene from Tomb Raider, a conflict between the female protagonist and a monster. Let's analyze what the most difficult part is if I want to achieve this effect. It is actually the consistency between the entire scene and the character. When we generate a unified short film, we need to maintain overall consistency in style. This implicitly involves two key elements. One is the character, and the second is the scene. This also includes our colors and lighting. These must all be consistent. So how do we achieve this today? We will look at a relatively simple method here. We will use a LoRA. This LoRA is specifically for Qwen Image Edit Plus, which is the 2509 version. What is its name? It is called Next Scene, meaning the next scene. It can infer the next scene based on the previous image. Naturally, this ensures the consistency of the character, the scene, and the overall lighting and style. In the file list, we can see this LoRA, which is 295 megabytes in size. Additionally, there is an example workflow that you can download. Of course, you can also build it yourself, as it is very simple. When using it, let's pay attention to the parameter settings. Our main model uses Qwen Image Edit 2509, which is the version we often call Plus. Please note, do not set the weight too high. We can set it to 0.7 to 0.8, and our trigger word is next scene. This ensures that based on our input image, it can infer what the next scene will be. Now, let's build a workflow to demonstrate its basic usage. I have built this workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub. In the field of ComfUI, Running Hub is a fantastic online working platform because whenever new technology emerges, they follow up immediately. Everyone can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in the video description. This way, you can receive 1,000 free credits. Additionally, you also receive 100 bonus credits just by logging into Running Hub every day. This allows you to try out your own workflows. Take a look. This is a standard Qwen Image Edit Plus workflow. The difference between this and traditional edit models is that it can accept 3 reference images. First, we load the main model, the Qwen Image Edit 2509 version. Note that I am currently using the FP8 model. Next, we load an acceleration LoRA. This LoRA comes from Light X to V, which has created many acceleration models. In the Qwen Image Lightning folder, you can find a subfolder called Qwen Image Edit 2509 inside. There are 4-step and 8-step acceleration LoRAs. You can download them according to your needs. I have currently downloaded the 4-step one. Please note, we are now loading the next scene LoRA and setting its weight to 0.7. Then we have our encoder and VAE. Here is a reference image, and the prompt we write is next scene. If we only write this trigger word, the effect is not very obvious. For example, let's run it now. If we only write the trigger word, you will find that apart from a slight change in resolution and the addition of cinematic black bars, not much else has changed. The overall composition is also similar. Therefore, if you want it to work effectively, you must clearly describe what the next scene is. For instance, I write, "The woman is running." Now the entire scene changes. These two images maintain consistency in overall lighting and style, and the environment is also largely consistent. Ultimately, if you want it to be effective, you must provide a basic description of the next scene. Of course, you can change the perspective. For example, I write from left, and to ensure it works, I can also add profile, which is a side view. If we sample again, you will notice that the image generation itself is fine. However, in terms of a scene transition, it has a fatal flaw. You can see that the entire background hasn't actually changed, only the person's action has changed to a side view. If we look at this image individually, there's no problem. But for a scene transition, the character wouldn't just turn in place, right? If the camera is turning, the background should also change. Therefore, everyone should pay attention to this issue when switching perspectives. Of course, we can change the environment. For instance, we write near the river. Take a look. The overall style generated is quite similar to the input, but there are still some changes. So you can change the environment, but the environment should remain as consistent as possible with the original one. If you write about running inside a tomb passage, the overall style is much more similar. Let's try it. Now, the image we generated is much clearer. The broad environment is consistent inside a passage or a tomb. Then we describe her action. This way, the overall style change is minimal. If we had used the previous near the river prompt, where the large environment changed significantly, the consistency would be lost to some extent. This is the basic usage of this LoRA. Now, if we want to create an AI film that has a strong sense of narrative, how should we proceed? First, you need to design the scene. I suggest that everyone still uses a large language model LM for the design. For example, I want to create a story similar to Tomb Raider, featuring the protagonist and a monster. I also hope to break down this story into 5 panel shots. For each panel, I want it to be described using a piece of text. For the main character, I want it to be simply written as the woman. Why? Because we will have a reference image later. I don't want it to provide a very detailed description of the character. On the contrary, I want it to provide a detailed description of the environment and the visual frame. However, I want the story to be limited to a broad, consistent environment. This is what we mentioned earlier, limiting the large environment is extremely helpful for consistency. Then, we can generate 5 prompts. You can use these prompts as a reference to generate images. The first image must be generated using text-to-image, so I suggest everyone use a prompt generator similar to this one to refine it. Now, take a look. This is the first image I generated. I used the standard Qwen and a JSON format prompt. I got this image, which is very beautiful. I think the overall lighting and character details are done excellently. Once this image is generated, we can proceed to generate the second one. For the second image, you can use the reference generation method. Take a look, this is my second image. This time, I use the Qwen Image Edit Plus, which is the 2509 version, and employed the next scene LoRA. Furthermore, we must write the trigger word in the prompt, followed by a clear description of what the second scene looks like. It can refer to this image of ours to generate the second scene. Similarly, I can generate the third, fourth, and fifth scenes. Thus, we have 5 scenes. What we need to do next is image to video conversion, generating videos from these 5 images. There are many options here. You could use Gen 2.2, or of course other models. What I used here is Grok, which we discussed in the previous lesson, because the quality of the videos generated by Grok is very high, especially regarding dynamism. We provided a detailed analysis of this previously. Therefore, for these 5 scenes, I generated corresponding videos for each one. The quality of every video is excellent and highly dynamic. After generating these 5 videos, we still need to do some editing. The editing primarily involves generating background music. Although Grok comes with sound effects, since the clips are segmented, the sound is inconsistent. Therefore, we should try our best to add unified background music. Then, we apply some basic speed changes to each shot, and then export the film. This significantly improves the overall quality and texture. This is the final completed film that you all saw. How was that? Isn't it incredibly clever? So, a complete piece of work requires many steps, but among them, there is one crucial step. The LoRA we discussed today is that most critical step in the entire production. Alright, that is all for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.